People with steel testicles hanging from the back of your vehicles. Why? A family with a weird sense of humor bought me one. It was because I taped a fake hand on top of his car that he didn't notice for 3 days and was laughing madly when someone told him about it. I did this during the Thanksgiving holiday. Halloween was way over. Anyways, he gave me one because I screamed like a girl when he showed me his pet chihuahua and he thinks I need some balls if a tiny dog is gonna scare me. I miss you, Bill. You weird asshole. The realistic rubber ones with hair are way more unsettling. My brother has some hanging off his truck. His answer was at a rubber course. It makes me laugh. And it ain't not hurting anyone, so who cares? My friend had two earths dangling on his Prius. It was hilarious. He drove as fast as it would go to. Still not fast, but then those earth nuts were staring at you, and you couldn't help but laugh. My guess is, because the pissing Calvin decals just aren't cool anymore. You always see them on those lifted trucks. But I used to want them back, when I drove a hand-me-down sensible family sedan from 1995. Just to make people wonder. It, literally nobody who has these. Imagine if women who felt inadequate mounted flashlights to their bumpers. To show everyone I have a tiny penis. The name of the part of a passenger truck, where trailers are hitched, is called a ball mount. Therefore, some fake balls are mounted on the ball mount. That's the joke. Well, it would look pretty stupid on the front of my vehicle, wouldn't it? Kinda funny. I noticed a trend of people having them on their bicycles in Japan on a visit this past spring. Not a person with steel testicles hanging from the back of my vehicle, but I feel like it's not hard to figure out. The people who do somehow actually like them. They either find them funny or cool. Some people just have bad taste. There was a good article about it. Apparently most of them are owned by people who think it is ironic. To drive you nuts. Makes my Miata look tougher. If you brake check, you can teabag tailgaters. Removed. Why are you looking at the truck's testicles? Probably because it's funny to them. And because the people who get upset about it are the exact people they enjoy messing with. I wanted to be able to spot my Prius in the Whole Foods parking lot. I've got balls of steel. I've got balls of brass. In stormy weather, they clang together, and sparks shoot out my ass. My buddy had a pair of these in high school, and hung them on the back of his familiar's minivan before a long road trip without them noticing. His dad kept remarking on how many people on the road were waving and honking, and could not for the life of him figure out why. My truck had self-confidence issues, and after a few months of therapy it finally opened up to me, and told me it identified as a male. I have recently learned that you can get rubber ones to hang off the back of your bicycle seat. At one time I drove a tiny Cario, like literally the cheapest car you could get new. Wasn't a terrible vehicle, got good gas mileage out of the thing. But yeah, it wasn't impressing anyone. I never got them. But I often joked that I would get a pair of truck nuts for it. But they'd be dragging on the asphalt. I don't have them, but I think the extreme level of kitsch makes them an absolutely delightful absurdity. Better question is, why aren't more of them painted blue by concerned citizens? Because my vehicle lost its real testicles in a horrible accident, and I didn't want it to lose self-esteem. A guy in my old neighborhood had a big sticker decal on the back of his truck that said "Get you some big DAWG nuts." If that doesn't also break the douche scale, IDK what does? What the fuck? I didn't even know that was a thing. I just googled it, I'm speechless. If people are wondering if you're a doucher bag or not, you don't have to actually answer. I don't. But at the factory I used to work at, when these first came out, we had a set that we would prank one another with by going to the parking lot and strapping them to each other's cars. It was just about having a sense of humor. Because I drive a VW Beetle, it had to be done. I think the mentality is are we not? It's so others can be aware there's a dick up front. To let everyone know there's a dick in the driver's seat. A dad on my brother's hockey team has a set of balls hanging from his minivan. It is the funniest shit ever. You see them all the time in Alberta. They are fun and funny. for a brief history lesson and hopefully to win some people over. There is an episode of the podcast Decodering, a truck nudzo, that I all need to listen to indicate to the world that there's a dick up front. I always wondered, if the balls are behind the vehicle, does that make the driver a dick then? They want to show to everyone that they are not compensating at all. I wanna get some, because I think it's funny. I'll find it and post a photo. At my workplace there's a dude in a lifted F-150 that has these hanging from it. Maybe he likes displaying his small dick in public. It matches the IE's ass decal on the back window of my truck. Because half of the bell curve is below average. Because they want to suck it. Fake balls hanging from trucks just screams I'm an insecure dude and realize I will never have a girlfriend because women think balls hanging from vehicles is gross.